Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on how to get started with a Blazor menu bar component from Syncfusion. In most of the web applications or websites, you would have seen the menu bar displayed at the header with navigation options like this. You would have also seen multi-level nested menu items like this. In this video, I'll explain how easy it is to add a Blazor menu bar component from Syncfusion to a server-side Blazor application. I will also show you how to configure few of its basic features like data binding, adding icons, multi-level nesting, and how to change its orientation. To explore the other features available in Syncfusion Blazor menu bar component, refer to the website link shown in the above YouTube card. Let me start with the application creation process. I can create Blazor application using either Visual Studio 2019 or Visual Studio Code. In this video, I'll show you how to create a server-side Blazor application using Visual Studio 2019. Make sure that you have installed it along with .NET Core SDK 3.1.2 or a later version. Now, I open Visual Studio 2019 and choose Create a New Project from the dashboard. I select a Blazor app from the templates and click the Next button. Here, I'll name my project and click the Create button. Then I choose the Blazor server app and click the create button. As you can see, the project has been created and is ready to use. Now I will show you the step-by-step process for adding a Blazor menu bar to it. To add and start using the menu bar, first I need to install the necessary Syncfusion Blazor packages. For that, I'll open the NuGet package manager, search for Syncfusion Blazor and install it into my application. Once it is installed, you can see the Blazor packages have been added to this application's packages folder. Next, to start using the menu bar component, first I'll navigate to the imports.razor page and import the namespace Syncfusion Blazor Navigations. Then I need to register the Syncfusion Blazor service. To do that, I navigate to the startup.cs file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Next, I make a call to the Syncfusion Blazor service method inside the configure services method. Then within the configure method, I register the Syncfusion license by passing the trial license key in the register license method. Next, I navigate to the host.cshtml page to add CSS reference from the installed Syncfusion Blazor packages. Now, the configuration steps are done. If you want to know more about the Blazor server app and how to add Syncfusion components to it, please check the video link shown in the above YouTube card. Let me continue to add the Blazor menu bar now. For that, I open the index component and include the SF menu tag. The menu is not visually displayed on the browser now as there are no menu items bound to it. To visualize the menu bar on a browser page, first I need to add the menu items. I will show you how to add menu item data to the menu bar to see its basic look and functionality. You can bind three types of data to a menu bar. They are hierarchical data, complex data, and self-referential data. I will show them one by one. First, let's see how to bind hierarchical data to a menu. I can directly write the C# code here using @code directive. I create a public variable menu items of type list and create the list of menu items. Next, I include the text property to specify the caption of the menu item and set its value to file. Then, I include the items property to specify the subitems and create a submenu item list. Here, using the menu item instance, I define the submenu items with the text property. Similarly, I have defined other menu items. Then, I assign this menu items list to the items property of the menu. Now, I will run my application by pressing FI key. You can see the output displaying the menu items. When I hover over the file menu item, its subitems are displayed in the menu pop-up. I can also add icons as a prefix to the menu items to provide visual representation of an action using icon CSS property. Here, I will add the icon for item file Under the Style section, I define the icon class e-file and set its content. Then I assign this class name to the icon CSS property of its corresponding menu item. As you can see, an icon is displayed for the file menu item. Now I will show you how to bind a complex data source by mapping the fields using the menu's fields property. I define a model class countryData, then define the property country of string type. Similarly, I also define the other properties with appropriate types. Next, I'll declare a list variable, namely menu items, based on the model class countryData. Here, I'm going to list the continents and its countries with language details in the submenu. First, I type the property continent and set its value to Asia. Then type the property countries and create another list. I add country property and specify its value to China. Here I'm going to show a subitem to the item China. I create another list with languages property. I'm sure you are familiar with this concept. Yes, it's nothing but a multi-level nesting. Now include the language property and set its value to Chinese. In the same way, I will construct other nested items as well. Now, I have constructed a complex data source. As I have already assigned this menu items variable to the items property, let me map the parent and child fields in the menu bar using the fields property to display the menu items. For that, I declare a public variable menu fields of type menu field settings and then create a new instance of menu field settings. I declare the text as a continent, country, and language. Then declare the children as countries and languages. I assign this variable to the fields property of the menu. See the output. When I hover on Asia, menu pop-up with Asian countries will be displayed. When I again hover over the country China, the pop-up with the Chinese language is shown. Next, I will show you how to bind self-referential data. I can populate menu items using self-referential data structure that contains parent ID mapping field. Let me define the menu items with a self-referential data now. I define a model class custom menu item and include the ID, text, and parent ID properties with appropriate types. Here, I declare menu items and create an instance of model class custom menu item and include the ID property to specify the element ID and set its value to parent 1. I include the text property to show the display text and set its value to events. Similarly, I define few other items. Here, I want to display music as the subitem for events. So, I add its ID, parent 1, to the parent ID property of music. I also add the ID of music, parent 7, to the parent ID property of folk. In the field settings, I map the ID, parent ID, and text properties from self-referential data to the item ID, parent ID, and text fields respectively. See the output. When I hover over events, pop-up with subitems is displayed. On further hovering over the item music, its subitem is shown. Finally, I will show you how to change the orientation of menu bar using the orientation property. Here, I include the orientation property and set its value to vertical. See the output, the menu items are aligned vertically. Now let me make a quick summary of what we have seen so far. I have shown you how to create a Blazor server app and add a navigation menu bar component to it. Then I showed you how to configure the menu bar with the three different structures of data binding, how to do multi-level nesting, add icons to the menu items, and display the menu bar in different orientations. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the video description below. You can also see about getting a free license key to use our Blazor products if you are eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.